This program is rated 13, recommended for family viewing.
Beautiful morning to you who's just joined in right here on yet another beautiful episode of Urban Today. It is the 16th of September 2019, and of course, if you're to check your calendar, today is the National Step Family or Step Brothers and Sisters Day. Now, for those of you who come from step families, this is a day set aside for you to actually go out and embrace your brothers and sisters, the relatives, and show them nothing but love. And moving on to, of course, another day that is also celebrated, or another event that is also celebrated on this particular day. We do have the National Working Parents Day. Yes, are you a father? Are you a mother out there? And of course, you're on a hustle, you're grinding. 16th September is also another day set as you to make sure that we do celebrate you for all the works and of course everything that you do put on the table. My name is Derek Ainadash, and of course today on the show we'll be discussing a lot of events coming through, looking at of course some couple of headlines that were making news over the weekend, and some stories that of course have brought us into another fresh week. We do have, you know, people living with HIV AIDS, and later on Kachai we'll be having that conversation of you who's actually living with HIV AIDS and some of the things that you actually need to watch out for from the former Miss Y Plus, as of course also doubling as the ambassador of people living with HIV. But away from that, I do have Willis Daly, who I'll be holding it down with for the next couple of minutes. Good morning to you, Willis.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm okay.
How was the weekend?
Well, as you can see, I'm still in my weekend mood.
I was gonna ask.
Some people usually think this is a Friday thing, but you know, I decided to switch it up and try to see what people think. You know, there are some people who are routine people. Like, they expect you to be in a suit on a Monday. Then there are some guys who are like, whatever you do, as long as it makes you happy.
For some reason, I actually thought you're not going to do this show. Like, okay. Or maybe, I don't know, because this last weekend, the weekend you threw, you know, your pre-nyege-nyege or after-nyege-nyege, whatever.
Yeah. We had a wonderful bonfire, storytelling, and
the dress code.
So I think a man was a chandi koko mutwe. Ne man was a yesu nsuida. Si man was a nezafi.
But anyway, so how was your weekend? Weekend was a lot of, you know, events here and there. The Premier League was, of course, making headlines. Arsenal wajira baby, ajibade compete after, you know, claiming the victory for 70 minutes. 70 minutes, you can't have a draw. Jackie Chandiru, apparently, at all the same rehab, kugamba. Chiech abadomo weekend, your side there.
Well, biogede kondo zeda, we kuja kucho tatade munti, we were shopping for our kids to go back to school today. So we were using the weekends to shop and prepare them, have these conversations with them. You're going to see this, you're going to see that. Preparing omwana de okusomera era olwaleero. So there was a divanji there on the road now taking kids to school, and some of them even got days off from work.
Explains the traffic jam.
Yeah, explains the traffic jam actually. And for the past 3 weeks to our day jam, ngatuumula muko, no take a mark 30 minutes. No gawa. A Saturday jam, no kazao. Nekati, time has come now, we have to wake up, you know, back. You know, to the 30 minutes before we wake up these days. Plus also a very sad story happened. A lion that was taken from the zoo to Fort Porto escaped after the driver swerved off the road and, you know, got sort of an accident. Lion in area in busy bidi. Yes.
What about the starving as
no?
No, that is starvation clearly. We were together at the zoo, and you know, this lady Dora was telling us about how they feed these animals. And then they feed it again on Wednesday. Don't you think this could have attributed to this kind of
accident? I don't think so. The lion got agitated because of the accident. It's a habituated animal. It's not a wild animal per se. So it was sort of threatened. But the doctors tried to dart it down. You know, nemagambo why.
Aba Uganda Wildlife baji kutena labi ba release in the press release.
Baji senant.
Baji senant.
Baji kubia masasi.
Chitalo nyo. Anyway, na ina labi yunga King Oyo, of course, owe toronga, jogi la kawa kutwita yunga, gamba yada aji labi yeko.
Yeah.
Do I think baji later during, you know, the 25th coronation.
Coronation, yes.
Yes.
The mpango. But, you know, the story was sort of going to drift away. People were sort of going to start attacking the Toro Kingdom. And saying, why are you using Uganda's wildlife, you know, things to come and celebrate your cultural things? But the Uganda Wildlife Authority, in a statement, said that they had taken it there for, you know, study purposes, you know, to display there so people can have a feel of what Uwek is doing with the animals. That's a conversation. Yanyingiza weekend.
Talking about another conversation is Yanyingiza weekend. Unfortunately, yesterday, ngabo ogami ntabazade wade watu alaba na masomero, abazade ngabako yenyo. Waliwa kafawa kaina musauna we na mugonga ungo yambuka. Apparently, it exploded and of course had 5 employees that, you know, succumbed to minor injuries. Kate, another twisting story of this. Mbu. Apparently, this is an imbu.
Mbu.
Jackie Chandiru. Was in the sauna. According to some sources, Bagamambu Jackie Chandiru, your Rattle Assembly, how to manage to go Bala Mada against the Mula Banasa and Atari on Saturday, the Gurina again, I come Casauna.
NTV, honestly, Jackie Chandiru's story is a very heartbreaking story. When I saw Kolava story, Zembu, she was in a hospital in Naguru and she was walking around naked. I was like, but wait, where did we go wrong as society? And you know, there's, of course, it's a catch-22 situation. Some people point towards her and say you should take responsibility for your actions, which I think is adult. Everyone needs to take care of, you know, responsibility of their own actions.
Okay.
You know, you can't afford to say that, you know, people have to be sympathetic towards you because
of your addictions
and whatnot. You have to take responsibility for your actions.
Okay.
But also the other human, peaceful sort of angle. And people are saying, Tumuyambi, you know, let's just come
together. I think she even released a song. She was on a couple of, you know, magazine top covers, you know, events. And we thought, you know, Chandiru would be back. There was also a rumor that, you know, Blue Threes could actually, you know, merge back into the music industry. But now, looking at how things are unfolding, what exactly do we have left for Chandiru?
Well, I think Waliwe Mbuzi. Waliwe Mbuzi. Mbuzi. There are some guys who constantly, you know, find her at her weakest moment and then give her just one piece of drug. It sort of bring her back into you know, where she was. But she needs to get the strength.
Okay.
I keep telling people that, you know, you need to work for yourself. This world owes you nothing. So if you want to be better, you need to work by yourself.
Okay.
So if she needs to get better, it needs to start with her. If we see her making progress, then we shall be like, you know what? Let's just jump on this.
That's when we'll probably jump on this.
Okay.
A couple of news, of course, made headlines over the weekend. And, of course, from Friday, I think, into the weekend. And later on today, we also got some news regarding, of course, our former IGP, that is General Kari Kaihura, who has been sanctioned by the U.S.
I saw those things and I was saying, why? Wait. Then I saw someone tweeting and saying, you know, Wanda Museveni said in police, there's Kawoko. Nze simanyo owawe wogera ko bituufu obani.
Ya byeganya gambye bintu eba mwogera ko matugambuzi bamusiba ko bisibe.
Era bwo tunulamu no gama nti omuntu ade IGP ebbanga lino lyonna.
Yes.
For almost a decade, if I'm not mistaken. There is not a single time where I had someone accuse General Kaihura of smuggling drugs. And when you look through his history as, you know, IGP.
Yes.
Omulabanga, he was a guy who used to, every now and then they were banning drugs, I think, here in Naguru. No, Nsambia, Nungabocha drugs. Gwenzo wena mofisi yongo la akakade karamba akadola wako cha wali. Noka wako oda wako uchi.
Babu chadeko ogoku, what is it called? Kuto charinga abantu during his tenure. Nebamu chekako ogoku abantu, you know, nebamu affiliating ako that border border 10 gang that of course we all know about. Nebamu chekako kwa corruption. A lot of, you know, cases have come, you know, thrown onto him. Na hiya video ina agama mbe, yu nchevi yu natabima nyi.
Chema iti msajia ya soma amateka. Wetina haba chitufu. If it's true that he did these things, they will try.
Okay.
You know, he'll accept to come before court and they'll try him.
But what do you think these sanctions could mean to, you know, Kale Kaihura?
Well, I think that they are dent on his career as an individual and his personality. When a document like that comes through, of course, it just turns out it would jamanya never try na kumanya. So it's bad. It's bad.
Tugeza koko recovering ngamu chintu ndi kani chintu bachi mojamu.
Na ya te katiba musude ba muziza. So for him, the next, you know, couple of months are going to be tight for him in that regard. But I hope that, you know, we just get to find out the truth.
Okay.
Inga bantu. Umanyo wa nama uli lorusu taking sides. Such things come on and say, hey, bam kute, bam. Neda. Court has not proved him guilty or innocent. So just really, that's
right. Just Donald Trump making a fuss out of it.
Yeah.
Ate Donald Trump in Oviagal. But anyway, it's a developing story. And of course, we're definitely sure that as the week gets to unfold, we'll have more, you know, interviews coming in regarding this particular one and keeping you informed with what the sanctions could mean for, of course, our former IGP. But moving away from that, beautiful Monday morning down here in Kampala, and we'd like to let you know what is making headlines in our starting news. Now, apparently, Uganda has joined and, of course, is now going to be marking the International Day of Democracy. Uganda has joined the rest of the world in commemorating the International Day of Democracy with a call to the people to remember that democracy flourishes when people feel represented. The day is marked every September 15th, and this year's edition was themed Participation. With Uganda's 2021 general election in sight, the youth have been urged to actively and peacefully lead and participate in the ongoing and upcoming events and activities that have a bearing on the forthcoming polls. Crispin Kaheru said that they call on the young people to actively and peacefully lead and participate in the ongoing and upcoming activities that have a bearing of the 2021 general election, including registering of national IDs, clearly indicating their preferred place of voting.
Well,
finally, we've joined, apparently.
With
that's what, according to, you know, that's no, why
those are, I think those are NGOs, you know, just want to make an extra buck. Because if you go back to what reality is, humanity naturally is democratic.
Yeah.
Humanity, every human being is democratic. Now, if you come to leadership and whatnot, of course, they'll say this one is an extreme, it's their dictatorships. But even in that dictatorship, that dictator sits down with certain people and says, Wanai, how many of you agree?
So there's a bit of democracy.
There's always some democracy somewhere. But I think it's a good thing. And now, you know, probably Katugena Funaba International Observer, Banji.
President of dictatorship keko but anyway, there you have it. And of course, this day was celebrated yesterday, and we'll be looking forward to, of course, seeing how democracy is unfolded down here in the country as we get to look forward into the 2021 general elections. Now, moving on from that, still getting into some shout-outs that are always making news also down here on this show. My shout-out is going into the government of Uganda. What have they done this time around? The government has come up to say that they're going to be regulating and certifying workplaces best learning. Now, apparently, government has started a process to regulate workplace best learning, that is the WBL, that includes internship and apprenticeship, in order to address the skill gap in the labor market. The Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development has this week been conducting consultations with district labor officers and district education officers to get their input in the regulatory impact assessment that seeks to form the completion of WBL policy. Mr. Turiasima said that the WBL policy basically means imparting skills within the workplace. So many people are acquiring skills through informal means. We want them to be certified so that they are compared with those who acquire formal education. While opening the consultation week in Gulu District, Mr. Milton Turiasima, the Assistant Commissioner for Employment Services at the Ministry of Gender, said they are working with the Education Ministry to have the certification for interns and apprentices. I think it's a good thing as far as, you know, anyone getting into the employment sector is concerned.
I think it's great. I think it's great. Government, the public service sector, is it? I think the public service sector has, you know, had a budget for some private businesses to invest in their interns. And if you have 3 interns, you go register with them. They give you some money so that you take care of those people interning. So I think it's a good thing that, you know, we are stepping up. We're trying to sort of have space for people who are learning. For example, a doctor, chiba chizibu nyo doctor kola kumuntu. So we need some come money to have what these doctors are going to use during their interns. Okay. So I think it's a good initiative for me.
All right, let's get into, of course, more shout outs coming in right here. They say that this shout out this morning is going into the Rising Women Initiative. Now, apparently, for any woman out there, I beg you to open your ears. This initiative is aimed at inspiring entrepreneurs and investors to scale up the heights in their chosen enterprises. It was all excitement as women were taken through Rising Women Entrepreneurship Training in Golo District. A total of 130 women in businesses such as bakery, coconut oil, design, tourism, poultry, paper, and gas, as well as oil seed extraction, showed up. The training is supposed and supported to be by the National Media Group, Women in Business, and Uganda Investment Authority. That entrepreneurs were equipped with skills in marketing, branding, customer care, and certification of their products in order to reach a wider market. This is a plus news for all the women, of course, especially those are best in Gula, I must say.
We also need organizations like Rising Man Initiative. Because, you know, the boy child has been left out. Yeah, when you look around, most of these guys who are committing crimes are men. Actually, 90% of crimes committed in Uganda are committed by men. So we also need to think about the boy child.
But who is the actual cause of these crimes committed by men? And isn't it women?
It's them.
Because at the end of the day, if you look at people involved in a crime, they want to get that kamane to take care of that.
Of their family.
They want to look for that kamane to take care of their family.
So I think Twitter got Rising Man Initiatives. Initiatives is Yama. What a rising man.
Rising man. But while you are waiting for skill work, planting every movie.
Hey. And then we have skill work, simbe muri.
And then we have skill work, simbe njaga.
For me this morning, I'd like to shout out to a very wonderful woman, and that is Nakate Vanessa. She's a 22-year-old Ugandan who has been, posting photos of herself holding a sign, and sometimes she's putting these pictures on Twitter. She's standing outside, and she's, the signs read, Green Love, Green Peace, Beat Plastic, Polythene Pollution, Climate Strike Now. Vanessa has declared a one-person hunger strike every Friday with hope that this will raise awareness on climate change. Nakate says she's afraid of the future of her country. Several countries in Africa, including Uganda, at a risk of desertification, a process where previously fertile agricultural land slowly becomes a desert. Desertification is often a result of droughts, elevated temperatures, and deforestation, all which are connected to climate change. I think hands up for Vanessa.
She's
really doing a good job. Well, the organizations like New Vision have come up to say we are planting a million trees. NEMA has pushed for let's plant trees. But I think that's not the problem. I think Vanessa is tackling the actual problem. And the problem is that, you know, we have a lot of polythene bags. We have a lot of pollution. We have a lot of tree cutting. It's not the number of trees that have reduced. It's our habits.
Is Vanessa in Uganda?
She's in Uganda.
I think, you know, we should do the connection.
We should.
And our very own CEO.
I think we should be with New Vision's project now to plant a lot of trees. I think it's a good thing that, you know, we need to get in touch with her and see what's happening. And lots of young people ought to be concerned. Faba kuze, wakati nzenkuze. Nzenkuze, nsisi China chenje taza. Na hivu nobya miaka 15 kwa abiri yabo, wage nofuno obuzibu. Ngakasana kocha Kampala no ulidanga ne Musa okakocheza.
Katitekana tani kakocha.
Tekana ba.
Katikali ku warm up.
Era abana bafebe tuzala bachi no kusamu ekintu kya Vanessa kino.
Ekitegeera. Saji abudde na abagamba my brothers you better make money or else they will tell you good night and she'll still be online.
Because imagine this. There are kids out there. For example, yesterday I was taking kids back to school. But you know, a parent walks into a supermarket, they buy lots of stuff. Put them in lots of buveras, carries to the kids' case. But what if you thought about it and said, look, I'm going to buy these things for my kids, and the kids are going to put them in their suitcases. Let me go with their suitcases and put the things there directly. akabirubuka suti ubuka jeo so ibintu ngebe bitini chinyewe
naye wali amaso actually amaso mere nakuzo mtigacha kiliza bubela I think last term I was going to St. Lawrence to visit some of my cousins there. Watu wakachuja na watu gamba uvera uvera eh
mubuzeyo
uvera ne babu jamba atatu buzeyo ne babu jamba ali wabo cheza au kaka the gate ngolo yali wali just amira
say something say something I think that's what we need to do yeah. You know all over naika tinabaza de na obachitandike nti omwana akoma okusomero ulwacha studa kavera kava demo yeah.
That's very true. There you have it, of course, for some of the shout-outs coming in right here on the show. Being a very beautiful Monday morning, like I did mention, it is the 16th of September 2019. We do have the dailies that are out, keeping you informed now. Up next is the Press Digest. Beginning off with the new vision going for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings, that is for the hard copy. And in case you're traveling, you're on the go, there's the vision app that you can always download both at the Play Store as well as Google Store. And of course, you do that, you do have a copy of the new vision, only 1,000 Ugandan shillings. The headline is nothing rather than something that we were talking about, they're saying that government speaks out on Kaihura's US sanctions. They say it will not intervene with the matter. Details on page 5. If you're general, if you get that,
no, the stories will be told. Mm. The truth will come out finally. Of course, you know, omuntu wabera mbukulembeze ne waba Trump, ne waba ani, abako ne bintu byakola, ukitegera, abako ne bintu byokola to sacrifice something for the better good. You know, so people make judgment calls, and some of these things are, I think, what are haunting General Kale Kaihura.
Rukuntan has come up to actually say something regarding this one. He says that the U.S. is a sovereign country. It takes its decision the way it wants to take them. If they say we do not want so and so in our country, who are we to say that, you know, you should have him?
Yeah. Beba Sarao.
Beba Sarao.
Enjoy him.
Yeah. It's a moving story.
It's a moving story.
Being a Monday, we do say that we have 9 pages of job openings inside the new vision. And of course, they are saying that Muhoozi Grace's Busoga celebrations, they do have a pictorial right there. And on our spotlight, they say that cartels places patients in hospitals. Grab yourself a copy of the new vision right there. Nagrinya coming in right here to say police has been questioned regarding the husband again, and a lot much more. President Yoram 70 tips youth on wealth creation. We did see him as, of course, he addressed one of the ceremonies regarding graduation down in, of course, our neighboring districts in outside Kampala. Then we do have some more news coming in as far as UN guiding electoral commission ahead of the 2021 election. You can as well grab yourself a copy of the new vision and get to catch up with that. How criminal health network places patients in Jinja Kawolo hospitals. This is of course the second part in case you've been following up on the series regarding this particular one only in the new vision. Being a manly, of course, we do not forget the fact that we have to take care of your health and beautiness. We do have that pull out coming in right here. They say that how to get out of the office chair alive. We definitely know that most of the people do have office jobs whereby they tend to sit on their chairs more than 8 hours a day. Now the new vision is actually bringing you details on how to get out of that office chair when you are still alive. So do grab yourself a copy of the new vision. Those of you who do have back pain, they are talking about what leads to this back pain, why you need to act as soon as possible. The infrastructure pullout is also here. They're talking about the Entebbe GT to reduce fuel pump prices. Okay, wait and see how this one gets to unfold, bringing you all the news regarding infrastructure. International news coming in right here. They say that African leaders praise Mugabe at state funeral in divided Zimbabwe. Grab yourself a copy of the new vision. The current president of Zimbabwe himself coming out to say that we honor and remember African icon. He had many allies and followers. Our motherland is in tears. He also had, I think, the most enemies across Europe. But anyway, you can grab yourself a copy of the new vision and get to catch up with those details right there. International, of course, the EPL was making headlines in some sports and news. You can as well get to catch up with that at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings.
Mubukede wa unakurareo nga ulijowe nkugama nchisonga ziri satu norareo nchisonga yokuna ya Amerika kubanti etabu kidekale Kaihura ejokuwe nchisonga yokuna. Ne yokuwineso kanti bukede wa nusu lukumi ili mwembozi ezimbi na daladala. Obikula kupeje mkaga chaba zinga ajukiza government vivajibanja uno wano mchifana nyinga kube ngoma of course, last week was a very, very huge celebration. So as a conversation, Ntiruachi Bobi Wine yabadde okubeeranga congratulating abetoro okuba nti ba celebrating ze ate ne irabira kyabazinga okuba nti am congratulating
ebintu ebyo tebyabadde wamu ne gwonde ne
byabadde
omanyi Bobi Wine yabadde hoima
yabadde hoima katwiti koka naye teyasobodde kati kayo kati abemusoga agawa musajja tumuveeko
tumwesonyi
musajja tumwesonyi jero kaye kaihura bamutaddeko obujulizi bwa myaka 10 miramba gulabuke domanye bujulizi ki ate wano agamba nti lwaki America esaze okumusitukiramu agambe nti kyandibanga kyekwasaako n'emisango kkooti y'amagye jeri mukuwulize saawe zino gulabukedde
kkooti y'amagye emisango yagidrope
emisango gikyayo naye lwakuba tebanagiyita
girimu abanene mu gavumenti
kamera zaabukedde zaanisa abasawo b'ekawolo kunguzi story ni atani kukubanga ejamu omunyo ne sukari tamale mirundi we yagamba nti wali abasawo abagena nga batta abantu ne babajamu ebintu yo ne babitunda kati story ine kuze mbuke dona ko lalero muri mu paspel e omwana wabo muza msomero funa ogula buke doka jemu kamuwe musibire ntana nti akomeo nga agudde anonye jadda peja biri abamanyi ebyemikono
abamanyi ebyemikono
omweta go kugezesebwa lwachi gulabukedde omanyi ebisinga obikulabikula nojja ku back page Serena Williams uno ali mu kifaananyi gulomanyi bamubyogera ko KCCN Pro Line zezize kisaawe kya kapeti tebaagala abaana edda ffe twasamiranga mbigere lwachi munswaza Gadiola akyusiza abazanyi be olw'okuvuya bade bavuya wano kwega binji mbukedde ani alina enchizo KCCN Pro Line babibuziza nebirala binji biri mbukedde olwalero
kitufu nyacho. But of course, if you're to buy yourself a copy of the Daily Monitor, its headline is saying that Entebbe duo killing, new details emerge. Shooting was preceded by meat at the fuel station. Shots rang when police was near the scene. Toll gate lightning was off. Men, the victims, as of course, met, drove a Harrier. Details on page 4. And then, of course, in the news summary, they're saying Besigye rights activists praise U.S. ban on Kale. He already is praising the U.S. according to the new ban.
He had to. Yeah. But you see, Africa, Chitulemesa, as Africans, is always looking out of our plates and looking into, you know, other people's plates. The U.S. is trying to do its own thing. We with these cases on Kaihura. What this should be helping Uganda is that now Uganda should open its eyes to say, okay, what do we do as us? Instead of saying, hey, msajja, hey, bamutwale, msajja wawano, yazali wawano, yakulira wawano, yasomira wawano.
I think we should put our differences aside.
Yeah.
We all know Besigye and Kaihura clearly can never be on the same page. Given the tear gas the man has swallowed, but...
As for me, I think as an African leader, you need to overlook certain things. You need to look, because Besigye has huge numbers behind him.
Yes.
Huge numbers. He needs to look like 20 years into the future and know, you know what, Kano, knows that Katuze to push in. You know, authorities need to look into this.
Into this, not
to be happy. You know, guy.
Yeah, you're about to watch Nagamba. Then, of course, in other news, in the Daily Monitor, they're saying that NEMA defies Museveni on rail wetlands. NEMA has ignored a presidential directive and issued an operational license to a Chinese company to extend its rice fields in rail wetlands on the Kampala-Masaka Highway. This is on page 5 to Tumani, how this one is going to unfold. Let's wait and see. Then school opens for third term. We do have a picture of kids right there in the tax park. Ten killed in two road accidents. You grab yourself a copy of the new vision. That's another sad situation. Why Kampala Jinja Express Highway has delayed teaching and learning. Of course, so we do have that pull out making headlines in today's copy of the new vision. How anger in parliament flowed up Buganda riots. get yourself a copy of the new vision right there. And of course, I'm not forgetting the fact that we do have some sports news coming in right here at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings. So as you do head there to your small Kafunda to look for that coin, make sure you grab a copy of these dailies in order for you to be informed with what is happening within and outside the country. I'm going to take us in for a very short break, but when we do get back, it will be Kachai, and we shall be talking everything that you need to know as far as living with HIV is concerned.